Welcome back, everybody. Let's jump ourselves directly inside the game because we have had ourselves a little bit of a mistake on the joint at his end. My bad. We have had a problem where we DC'd out the game prematurely. All the players were doing so as well. So we will be streaming off this game from the Chinese live stream. That is the guys who are controlling the camera. So I get to have some time off, enjoying my time with this one. Casting with me is the Muffin Man. He'll also be doing the same thing for this. But yes, we are inside the game. It's LGD International versus LGD. DCN, and would you believe I'm not the first one to miss First Blood. Isn't the Evoker going down in the middle lane? There will be no in-game sounds for this, by the way. There's no in-game sounds for this one, and there'll be no Dota TV audio from myself. Or Muffin Man. But yeah, we are here, and we will still broadcast this one out.
This is something you can blame Toby for, guys.
Yeah, my bad.
Just to let you know.
My bad. I am happy to accept the beating. I'm more than happy to accept the beating on this one. But yeah, we are still looking at the game. We are still inside the game. And the fun thing is, too, we can see that action replay with the Invoker going down in the middle lane. But that's just, it's just smart ganky the other day. And this was one of those things I was worried that it wouldn't work as far as the Invoker in the middle lane. Just because of the possible aggression that can come out. We're actually now sitting at 2-0 in favor of LGD International.
Yeah, love the way 1437 and Misery play together on those supports. 1437 with the disruption sets it up for Misery, and then he creeps into stun and do all that stuff. And you were right about Brax being on that tide in the solo lane.
Mm-hmm. I say solo lane. He's kind of been supported a little bit too. Like, we've had 1437 and Misery rotate around to help him out.
And then they just go everywhere.
Yeah, instantly they're smoke gacking again. Like, we're 2 minutes 50 in. They've already managed to get one kill up on the middle lane, and they're already rotating again. And the setup is being done right now by the NA in mid. Like, it's Sergei again, just looking to shut down Xiao 8. But actually, then Misery, he's not rotating that way. They're rotating up towards the top, grabbing a creep, and then moving around. So it's just smart rotation.
Invoker always has to be scared and play on the back foot now. So, like, Zhao 8 can't play like he normally would if it was a pure solo v solo, which it never is in these games. But he's always got it in the back of his mind that SD and Chen could come, and now they're coming up top.
Yeah, so it is going to be tied straight in the mix. Like, Anchor Smash Disruption is there by 1437 as well, buying a little bit more time for Brax. That's a lot of damage on DDC. He will take a fall up on the top lane.
Yeah, that test of faith really dealing a lot of damage in that one. Like, it's a random, it could be a little damage, it could be a lot. They were lucky enough to get a lot, and the right clicks were enough to finish off the kill. Mm-hmm. International ahead by 3 kills.
Yeah, they're looking great, and Pykes down there on the bottom lane, he's finding all of his free farm he wants. Any kind of harassment which he is getting from the Magnetor, now with those Tranquil Boots up, he'll be able to survive it very, very easily. And the rotation again comes up towards the top. 1437 with the setup, and well, they're going to go back to an action replay for the moment, and that was the initiation initially with Brax trying to go on SC, and they managed to get a great disruption off, lock him inside the tree line, and that was that second kill which was missed after we jumped back to the action replay in the middle lane before. I got a funny feeling we might need another one in a moment after this top lane initiation. Nope, we're fine. It's 3-0.
Yeah, I just love the way International making decisions this game and the way they've laned it. They know the Luna can handle the mag and still come out with some good farm. So they're dedicating their supports on pressuring the lanes that need to be pressured, middle and top, mm-hmm. helping that Tide against that Lone Druid lane and helping that Nyx Assassin against the Invoker in mid.
Even SD, he's forced to be there in that mid lane, and they're just farming up, right now, LG International, they're not focusing any kind of attention, any kind of lane. And then, also an escape out for Yao on the bottom lane. He's now completely out of mana, he hasn't bought up his boots just yet, and he's a long way away from having those arcanes. So he can do anything up against Luna, who's just a right click, and with an early ring of Aquila, you're able to have that mana regen in where you can harass a little bit with the Lucent Beams. And up to level 4, then it's kind of worth it. Level 1, it's not really worth it up against a Magnetor.
Check out Pycat CS compared to the mag.
Yeah.
This is revenge for Pycat. He got beat by Yao's mag last game when he was Klinks, but now it's this time. He's doubling the Magnetor CS. And look at those denies, 22. That's all thanks to that extra damage from the aura. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's dominating this lane.
It's beautiful to watch if you're an international fan. Mm-hmm.
And it's without any support from his supports. It's all pure solo.
Yeah, the misery as well as 1437, they're dedicating all their time to making sure this top lane and middle lane is controlled. And Misery is still able to find creeps and still find levels inside the jungle. Now, if we get a click on him, we might see his level, but it's just... Right now, LGD International, I said they needed laning. They needed strong laning, and that's exactly what they've given.
Well, the thing is, you don't think of Nyx in mid or the Tide at top to be the strong lanes. It's all coming down to the support and how well they're playing. Like, they're like truly the focal point of this early game strategy.
Mm-hmm. By the way, just a reminder too, guys, if you're just tuning into the live stream, wondering where the game sound is, there is no game sound. Unfortunately, I made a mistake. We might have to wait for a moment. DDC is going to die up here on the top lane. Slightly out of position. It wasn't even slightly out of position. It's just the fact that they're capable of diving the tower in this kind of manner. Brax is searching for Sylar, and Sylar's on the run as fast as he can possibly go. Shadow Poison will see him, and there'll be a stun flying out in a moment, and that's going to stop 1437 from chasing. There's very minimal damage. That must be a level 1. Yeah, it's actually a level 2 strike array, but still very minimal damage. And they're going to dive on SC2. They know she's in there, trying to cut a path through the trees, and that does give it a little bit of a path out through the right-hand side, but Lucent beams and continue off with the damage. Disruption out in 1437, saving you from that lone druid's bear. And then the bear is still in the mix, but it can't do anything. It is a useless bear right now because the ability to dive on the towers and kill off these heroes.
Yeah, this time G's rotation to the tri lane has working out, unlike last game, and 5-0 International's way.
Yeah, so LGD International looking fantastic, 7:42 in. Still looking down that bottom lane because it looks like we've had a little bit of a rotation up. Luna is now up here on the top lane, so bottom lane Magnetor's finding his space to get his farm.
This is crazy. Luna already rotating. They're already looking to do that 5-man. Push together with the Luna. Like, that must be like the only reason that, like, she's left bottom lane to stop farming already at 8 minutes in.
And starts the harassment on DDC. How long is it going to be before Magnetor TPs himself up? He's walking, he's actually checking for the 8 minute rune in the bottom. There's a sentry wall going down, looking for SC. Impale is there. Troll trap not even required. The damage has already been done. Yao, he has TP'd in. Skewer's going to go astray. And then the disruption, making it so Yao can't finish the job. He does have this double damage rune, looking for 1437's life. And 1437 on the run. Is there a mana burn? Is there an impale? The impale is there. Mana burn, no mana left for it. Meanwhile, back over was Yao, 8 and Sylar. Holding on the tower, it's only one kill going the way. One quick ward also being dropped down by Misery, so we can see when LGD want to go out of here. And Yao kind of wants to finish off this troll, but getting blocked by his own creep on the way out. And they get back to the safety of the tier 1 tower, as well as the clan. Everyone's waiting on that top tower.
It's just non-stop action. This is crazy.
It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful.
It's beautiful too, yes.
And now we're going to see Brax... Just on that front lines, again, that bear harassment trying to do his job, but like this Tidehunter, he's already walking around with 815 life points. If he gets entangled, he's only going to be a little bit disappointed, and he's almost going to pop that level 6. Like, that Ravage isn't there just yet. Yeah. The fact that LGD are 5-manning topping this, it's really slowing it down. Maybe that's the only
it's
premature
absolutely
thing.
Absolutely crucial, you're right, but it's almost there, and then just not willing to let go. Like, neither team is willing to let give an inch here.
Look, it's 5-man versus 5-man on the tier 1.
Yeah, this is the new meta.
Oh, pick up Brax. They need the entangle. They haven't really got one just yet. The Cold Snap trying to combine up to bring him down. Not possible. He's still just... He's 17 experience points away from having that ultimate. Magnetor has already gone down the sidelines. 1437 was the one who managed to set him up for a pike. That was the one who managed to finish the job. And LGD now is 5v4, and that Ravage, it's there. It's up for the Tidehunter. He wants to use it. Already NA. Sentry Wall being dropped down. Entangled with the first paw swipe. Picked up. Thrown back down again. Sergei. Magic Wand Charges keep him alive for the moment. Lina will cop a fall. 8-0 right now. And LGD, they're not only securing this top lane, they're killing LGD while they do so.
And they haven't even had to use the Ravage yet. And that's just the power of Nyx. Like, if you try and focus him down, he's just going to pop that spiky carapace, and you're all going to get stunned. So what do you do? He's charging in, he's stunning you, he's hitting you. You like, turn around and try and kill him, you just get stunned.
And there's not much more you can do against it. And now LGD International are going to carry their momentum up on the top lane. There's a couple of wards on the deck. So there is still vision for LGD up here, but they've actually given it up. They're now here in the middle lane, but it's a dangerous thing to do. You already see that rotation coming from International.
Yeah, they tried to do as much damage as possible on that mid tower, but then they've realized the International team, they're already rotating the mid.
So this is just that time now where LGD, it actually worked for them in the end. Like you do a little bit of pressure on the middle. It's LG International really, really wanting to lose their tier one tower in the middle lane for the tier two tower up on top. It's not bad, but at this point of the game, holding their position is a lot better because you know what LGD can do. And now we're going to lose Xiao Wei in the middle lane. Completely out of position. One hiding that tier one tower. Maybe with Magic Wand, it's going to be enough to live through this, but no, it's not. The damage from Sergei is enough, but then Yao comes in. There's that Ravage from Brax, and Yao completely out. Now it's 10-0 on the sidelines, and they will take the Tier 1 tower, possibly do some damage to the Tier 2 tower in the mid.
Okay, this is the real LGD International. This is like with a draft much better than last game, and this is their potential right here, man. This is so great to see. 10-0, and they're dominating LGD China of all teams.
Mm-hmm. This is perfect for them. This is the LGD International I was waiting to see at the very, very start. But it didn't come. It didn't come. And LGD, CN were able to walk all over them in that first game. But this is just completely turned around.
There was not enough room for G to make plays. But here he's just using his aggression perfectly. It's just working out perfectly.
Tornado having a little bit of a backfire effect there on Xiao Wei. Yeah, now onto the front lines. Pycat instantly just dropping his life down a little bit. Don't know if you're trying to force a premature bottle charge out, and that's probably the reason why we're seeing Yao using that shockwave, because when he uses the bottle, he's going to get life and mana back again. So, hey, may as well regen both, not just have one capped out. But 13 minutes in, and it's 10-0 in favor. Like, you were asking me before, at the very, very start, going, well, what's your predictions for this game? And I said, like, LGDCN, if you're going to take it at face value, Syla is so dead on the top lane. Support is TPing in, but that damage is just to come through extra with a Vendetta after we've already had the Lucent Beam as well as extra damage with the Gush effect.
It just doesn't stop. They're always pressuring. They're always doing something. This is incredibly high-level play, I have to say. And the one hero I think LGD China needed this game was probably Coddle, just to blast off and slow down that push to put it to a stop. And they don't have that. They've had that in previous games, but not this game. They went with their Lina and Rubik pair, and it hasn't worked out. The Chen and the SD have proven to be superior this game.
Yao's dead. Again in the middle lane. Mana Burn even doing enough damage to try and bring him down. And he can't do anything to get away from this. Once that initial damage is done, the stun even from down the low ground, there's just no escape for the Magnetor. And like that level up in Skewer, he tried to get away, and there's that nerf on Skewer coming into play.
Yeah, what level is
two.
The Mag?
Level 5. Mag is level 5, level and that Skewer is 2.
Wow, level 5 Mag. And Pycat is level
9. Actually, no, he's got to be level 6 because he's got the ultimate up, so he must be higher than that. All I saw was 3 on Skewer, and two on Skewer and 3 on Shockwave at a quick glance.
Two on Skewer. So, he must be level 6. Still, like, Pycat's way ahead. And that was a pure solo v solo.
Middle lane, tier 2 tower's gone. We're 14 minutes in up against a lone druid, and it's like tier 2 tower's a lost. Top lane, Silas on the run from the NA. He's hoping for an entangle. All he needs is one entangle. Is that a blink dagger already up on the NA? He turns around for the bear, and there's a TP out. The illusions will spot it. Look for the impale. Syla, nowhere to go. He's already gone on that top lane.
Holy shit. He's just getting smacked about by just a Nyx now. This is insane.
Lone Druid can't do anything. Like, look at his points. He's 8 points up. His bear's not even level 4. Even if LGD want to push out the tower, they don't have to demolish with it. They can't have that extra bonus damage. They don't have the or the like the points up in raw. There's so much
and
missing.
That 13-minute radiance for the Scylla Bear you were talking about.
Yeah, that's not going to happen, is it? It's completely out the window for this one. That's 13 minutes in and 15 kills. Like LGT,
so,
like
so impressed.
What must be
so impressed by International?
What are LGDCN even thinking right now? What are they thinking as far as like we see a smoke coming out from them. maybe they're thinking they can issue out in that bottom lane, because there's obviously where the push is coming next. There's four heroes rotating down there. Pycat's already here. Misery is his army of the dead, plus an Ursa, plus a Centaur. They're going to have no mana right now, but they are still there.
Well, they're thinking delay as much as we can through the use of Invoker Cyclones.
And he's coming in behind.
Get that Radiance up Scylla Bear.
And he's coming in from behind, and he's instantly going to destroy that Invoker. You can just see it coming in right now,
yeah,
unless you're on the CN stream. And there's a pickup. Sentry wards are down, but DDC, he had to stay behind so he can get that telekinesis off, which means he loses his own life. NA gets stunned a little bit. Disruption from 1437, making sure he's okay, and the catch is up on the Invoker, and that'll hold him out. Tier 1 tower's gone on the bottom lane. Pycat claiming that one, and they just keep on, like, mowing down. It's going to be the Tier 2 tower on the bottom lane to go. Stay away from the EMP. Yao's not going to do much more. Creep wave's arriving in, like, maybe 10 seconds. And then that tier 2 tower's gone.
Notice the item pickup on G. He's got a blink on the Nyx for even better initiation. Like, you can't always rely on the Invis, the Vendetta, to get you in, because you know you've got to get past towers and sentries sometimes.
There's the blink in. So double stun on SC and the Ravage and the Anchor Smash. Ravage being stolen by DDC with EMP. Tornado knocking it. Not even the EMP in time. 3 euros on the sidelines. Disruption again. This is just prolonging the death of the Rubick. Lone Druid is the only one not involved in this one. 18-0. 17 minutes in. I'm wondering if LGG is even thinking about tapping out right now.
That execution, I tell you what, like, I was just talking about how, like, Blink is, like, a good choice for the Nyx, although, like, you don't see it often. There, that's why it is, and
oh, they're chasing
the execution.
Top. They're chasing top, they're chasing the Lone Druid. He's running inside the jungle as fast as he possibly can. TP support's coming into the Tier 2 tower, and there is your block. It is NA in front of Scylla. He has no real mana left, though, so he doesn't want to do it Spike Carapace, just in case there is an attack to follow through. But it is not the case.
What are LGD trying to think? What are they going to do?
You do wonder sometimes, man. Like, LGD CN, they're massively on the back foot. Their Lone Druid has no farm. The second they try and give him farm up on the top lane, there's a very, very fast rotation. It's a very, very fast rotation up towards that top lane. Every single Tier 1 tower is still remaining for LGD International. They don't want to lose that control. They know what happens if LGD gets their combo, if LGCN gets their combo right. You get the Magnetor Skewer in, reverse polarity, then Lina with her stun, Rubick with the Fade Bolt, maybe a Meteorite comes in from the Invoker, and again, not with his build. And then
they're
Lone Druid needs
game.
To entangle. It's,
they're playing this game so precise, so tight. It's almost like a perfect game. Like, they haven't lost towers. They won the lanes just the right way. They've moved to all the right places. It's 18-0. They're looking to win this game before 25 minutes. It's just so perfect. This is like the potential of a Western team under the same conditions, I think. Like, they've practiced, what, 2 months? Imagine these guys come TI3.
Come TI3, they're going to be a powerhouse, man. But that's, like, TI3 is still a long way away. Like, we're looking another 8 months on the calendar that I have to clock over before we hit that point. But yeah, the time and dedication
that
LGD.
Think of how much better they'll be by then, though.
Who knows? Who knows? Imagine what would happen if LGD International, like, come back. It's like, yeah, we'll compete in the Star Ladder for once, and then Na'Vi finally lose one. It's like one day of practice. And I saw the interview up on Na'Vi TV with Puppy, and he was just saying, yeah, I practiced for one day. It's like, yeah, LGD International, they are practicing every single day. They are so focused right now, and it's showing. It was a big hiccup in the first game, but it's showing so well here in the second. That Radiance is on its way, though, for LGD. It's going to be, what, 22 minutes at this rate?
Yeah, it's not like a fast Radiance by any means. It's below average, actually. But it's not even going to matter. Like, International, they're so farmed up, they're so leveled up that they can cop it. Like, especially if someone gets a pipe, that'll counteract the Radiance burn damage for a bit. So,
sorry, I'm just looking at the build out from NA. What do you do if you're getting melee attacked? Build a blade mail.
Blade mail on top of spiky carapace. It's beautiful.
No one from LGDCM will want to initiate on him, and he'll be the one initiating on them. Roshan gone. Pycat picks up the Aegis the Immortal. And even though they've got the mech and the Hand of God already up, there's no pipe, but you throw an Aegis the Immortal up on that Luna, you've got break your base abilities right now. They can go in and basically tank up LGD.
Yeah.
Luna to the front lines, Let them throw their abilities. Let Laguna Blade fly. Let that Fey Bolt drop down. It doesn't matter at the end of the day. Love even
it's just desperation, like spamming spells, just to hang in there for now. And, you know, International, they're coming in with a purpose. They're not wasting any time. They got the Aegis. Now they're looking to finish the game. No mucking around.
Yeah, it's looking absolutely perfect for them. And this is going to be, LGD. Even that bear, the bear has got like no items as it is. Like you buy the relic early on in hope of the Radiance, but it means you got no stability up on that bear at all. And Pycat already with like Alban Orb and full BKB up for him. Is he going to pop it to get away from that EMP? No, he just walks away instead. And then walks back into the tower for one hit. Mech Charge will pop and the creep wave will push in about 10 seconds time. At the same time, that bottom lane is kind of is splitting LGDCN.
It's a matter of time. It's a matter of time. They've got really good anti-push. So it's going to be a matter of picking down this tower unless there's a good opening to initiate.
Well, at this point, EMP Tornadoes are slowing down this push of LGD, but instantly you see like that NA, he jumps himself in the middle of the EMP Tornado, pops the Carapace and says, please damage me, because he's returning it back to LGD.
Yeah, it's got to be so annoying if you're LGD China.
Well, at this point, like they've kind of got to know that they're really they're pushing something bad uphill right now. And then easy harassment damage, the bear's on the front lines. At least the Radiance is up for them, but they want to try and focus on that bear. Another EMP Tornado going to go through. Spike Carapace, bear's on the tail right now of NA. Lucent Beam is doing his job. And Yahweh back in. There's a blink in. Ravage to go, but no one getting caught out. SC someone low life. There goes the Gush. Brax the one to get the kill. And Pycat popping the ultimate for absolutely nobody that's here. And they're waiting for the time. Yao, he's still waiting for that reverse polarity moment. And he can't find it. Lina's the only one on the sidelines, and that cost him two ulties. And maybe it's not over just yet. Cole Snap returning the damage to Xiao Wei. He's got to be really careful on that low life, even though he is so far back past the tier three tower. They can just jump him.
I think it's time to back off now. Brax basically said he had enough and just ran in there and vaulted. And I don't really think it was the right opening. As you can see, they only got the tower to half. So now they have to wait for a little while because they don't have Ravage, they don't have Luna's ultimate, and they don't have the BKB at the moment. They do still have the Aegis. So I don't. It's a question of how much time are they willing to wait to go in for the push again. That tower is below half, though. So that is a positive for International now.
Well, the Radiance won't be the Aegis Immortal won't be reclaimed before that Tide Ravage, as well as Eclipse's back off cooldown again. So they just go into the jungle, they farm up, and this can even work the way of LGDCN. Like you blow the Tide Ravage, you got one kill, okay, now they catch out the bear on the top lane, because LGDCN, they want to push back out again. The Lone Druid's Radiance Bear, like, it can do the job. And in the meantime, now Sylar's Bear's on, oh wait, that's on cooldown for 50 seconds. Oh man,
oh, wow.
This is just the worst possible thing that could happen for them right now. Pycat's going to lose a decent chunk of his mana, but he doesn't really care. Those arcane boosts will still bring him back up again shortly. But Sylar with over half a minute.
The radiance on that Spirit Bear is just disappeared effectively because you don't can't summon that Spirit Bear back, so you don't have that radiance. This is the small opening, but I don't think they're going to be able to. They're too low, maybe. Like the spam is just too much from China at the moment. They're playing the turtle game. It is frustrating, but you know, this is what happens when you get dominated so hard early on.
Yeah. All you can really do is just try and sit back and go, well, at one point I will be able to, like, push this back. But LGD, like, we're looking at them right now, five men sitting on the top lane. What is happening with LGD International? Moving up towards the top, buying up a couple of items. We already see Chen going inside his own jungle. So this is going to be Chen getting his creeps back again. And then grouping up as four to push out that top lane for one final go.
Can you see those
go.
Pings on the bottom lane? G, like with the purple pings, he was pinging bottom, like saying, hey, come on, don't lose this tower. Don't lose this tower.
Well, not one step back. There's no need to take a step back as well. And that farm is now Luna's, it's her mana style. Well, we got Nagus the Immortal counter up too. I'm wondering if that means 1 minute till the Aegis is reclaimed. I'm assuming it is, because the timing will be right for that.
My question is, does anyone on International have a pipe? Because a pipe...
Haven't seen one yet.
I think it's compulsory for this situation. They have to get a pipe.
Pipe would let them get through. Pipe would let them tank up. Like, they wouldn't really...
Yeah, you can cast it on the creep wave as well. So, like, the creep wave can sustain all those nukes a little better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just not happening just yet. And Shadow Demon doesn't have it. Like, Shadow Demon's got Vitality. Warhalo bottom lane. Invoker's already on the sidelines. And the BKB pops off from Luna. So now that that EMP Tornado is not there to stop LGD from pushing in, and Tide Ravage is up, Luna's ulti might be down, but that doesn't matter. Maybe they're even going to catch Rubick out. DDC, he's Soul Spy Carapace, but Brax is there. Gush and Death already. They get the kill.
Very nice. So here is the 20-second opening that they need. Is it enough?
It is. It should be. Invoker is even going to buy back right now, but doesn't matter. It's like the LGD cast is having a little bit of trouble with their own live stream pumping out. And there goes the EMP. No Tornado to follow up. NA straight onto the front lines. He wants to take up that damage, trying to force down the tier 3 towers. But it's just not enough at the end of the day. LGD, they fall back a little bit again. But level 3 Necro books up.
Yeah, they're putting everything into ending the game now. And like they should. There's just no point to muck around. They're still getting the farm. Look at that. 10,000 gold lead.
The LGD,
the experience.
That we're now looking at gold at 17,000, 18,000 advantage.
Yeah. It's like they know what they're doing. They know they've got the advantage and they're making the best use of it they can. It's just the lineup of the Chinese team is so good at delaying this push. It's just so hard to get up on the high ground with creeps and finish off towers. But once they do find that opening, then we'll see it all collapse like a house of cards.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Well, man, LGD, they really do feel like they're getting ready for the last push, which is funny because the Aegis Immortus now, like, obviously with it gone, is dangerous. It's dangerous to commit, but maybe they just don't care. They got ultis. They got NA initiation with Blade Mail and Blink. Like, you don't need much more. Push it and take
it. Where is that pipe? Where is the pipe? Have you seen a pipe yet?
No.
I can't control it because we're watching through the Chinese stream.
It hasn't arrived yet, man. It has not arrived yet.
I want a pipe.
You might get your pipe, man, but then again, maybe you won't. They're just waiting for the next Roshan. That's all this is really coming down to. They're not going to, like, LG International, like, these guys live in the same house. It'll come down to respect between these two teams. Like, you instantly know, as LGD International, just what LGDCN is capable of. They showed it in game one.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And they'll be quite happy to display it for them inside the Tier 3 base, under a Tier 3 tower inside their base. But LGD don't want to do that. Like, LGD International, they don't want to wait for that. Like, with an Aegis Immortal, they've got that, like, trump card.
Yeah. There's no point pushing now when you can get the Aegis in a matter of minutes. And as you can see, it flashed over to 1437 just for a moment. He's got a gem. So, look, they found that ward there. Mm-hmm. That was a good find for that ward. So, they pretty much, like, have the map on complete lockdown. Like, getting the gem to deward and keep complete map control. So, China, they're still boxed in to their base. Not really able to make many moves at all, apart from just spam waves. Like, it must be boring even for the players at this point because there's nothing they can do. That's just how well International have played this game and put themselves into the position they are.
Mm-hmm. There was the call up on the board just then. 1 minute until Roshan's going to respawn. Damn, I love these Chinese animations. They make life really, really easy.
Yeah, it's really nifty, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm just going to insert these things into the wonderful world of Joined at this live stream. Thanks, China, for all your ideas and professionalism. Love it. With that build-up trying to get towards the Sol Kuras. It's not even 1 minute,
and
man. Like that one minute was exaggerating.
International, of course. They know exactly when the Rosh is coming up. They're just sitting there.
Mm-hmm. Well, this
they don't want to waste a moment. They want to kill it as soon as it comes up and finish this game.
It shouldn't take them long to do so. Like, the damage output's already high enough. Like, look even like that net worth coming up for Luna. Like, she's sitting at almost 14k worth of net worth.
Oh, yeah. Predictions on how fast Rosh will die?
I give it 6 seconds, maybe 7 seconds. But
6 to 7.
At this point, okay, maybe they've been at it for 3, 4. Okay, it's taking a little bit too longer because Pycat got stunned.
It's because the supports aren't tanking.
Mm. There's that gush finally.
Minecraft got stunned a few.
Okay,
This
that was probably about 10 seconds if we're judging by the
Greeval
time they
Rose
went in.
Churn, I'm pretty sure it has a higher stun chance.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, just throw that
Did you see
analysis out
that
there.
chin?
Hmm?
Oh, yeah. Well, you didn't know about it?
No, I actually have not been able to play a single Greavel match. It's been really annoying the crap out of me, man.
Yeah, the Greaval Roshan is stronger.
Such a bloody
I'll
troll.
write a guide about it tomorrow, don't worry.
Fantastic, fantastic. Check it out. It follows the Muffin Man, and he'll explain the life of the universe and everything. That's beautiful.
Yeah, that too.
All right, we just had a couple of little spikes up on the Chinese stream just then. I don't know if it transferred over to you as well. But yeah, LGD, they're finally moving out of their base. And now they're finally going back into their base. They thought about coming out, and I think the only reason is because
Just for
NA
a
is currently
moment.
on the bottom lane, just free farming whatever he wants to. Ty's
I
the
mean,
only one that can buy the pipe, by the way.
just to check the weather, and they don't like it, so they're coming back inside.
There's a storm brewing. No, wait, that's the Tornado Invoker himself. All right, there's that. I thought for a moment with the re-pull of the bear that it was like, oh, NA just jumped smack bang in the middle because we are lagging like a pain in the butt right now on this live stream. Not that I'm watching a
Yeah,
Twitch.
I'm getting it too.
All right, cool. So it must be coming from them. There goes the bear. Already dead. Already dead. Sylas forced to take up the damage, forced to resummon too, so they know this bear is a resummoned bear, and the tier 3 tower is down.
Yeah,
If
that's all
they.
they wanted for now, just to get that tower down. It's much easier now to take the high ground here.
Let's see if they keep pushing in. Again, it's this stall up. Like, Pycast's trying to do whatever damage he can to the towers, but there's just the follow through isn't coming instantly through because LGD aren't giving them the best vision for it. They've already got a sentry wood up on that high ground. They don't want the vision for LGD International to be inside that base. Their sentry ward for the Dire is blocking them out. And then just Glaive, Pycat, picked up, thrown down. But they haven't finished the job just yet.
There's the mech.
Push in and go. The bear again, being stunned, Sylar with it. And remember those Glaives just bounce through absolutely everything. Look at DDC's life! He's not even being focused! It's the Rax that's being killed off, and DDC's down to 2/3 of his normal life points. And there's a big die by NA. He's back on top of the tier 4 towers looking for Yao, but not going to be lucky enough to find it. Bottom tower is being pressured out, and LGD really wanted to take out this mid. Possibilities are there. They keep forcing it out, and that Tide Ravage, remember that Blink to Ravage is still there. He can kill off this Rubick right now if he so desires to jump. And looks like Shadow Demon even going to get some more Pycats up on the field. Disrupting him up. Pycats on low life. Look at that damage already on Zhao 8. He's so low. Nearly Rax is forced. Blink and Burrow strike through. He was looking for the Invoker to send. Then skew it back in again. Trouble for Sergei. Lina's starting to fly, but Brax comes in. Big Ravage already. Yao's on the sidelines. Moving on to Syla. Zhao Wei tries to come back in for this one. Mag will buy back into the game. Then Rubick able to steal Anchor Smash. That's not going to help him because he never wants to be that close to LGD International. And they take the
thank
mid.
You, Spiky.
GG! GG is the call. We're going to jump ourselves off this spiking stream, so I apologize again. You can blame the living crap out of me. Go nuts. I am happy to accept this one. We will be in the game next time. Whoops, that's not right. We will be in the game in just a couple of moments' time for game number 3. Stick around. We'll be back. G League Season 2.